And speaking of New York, you have a flawless American accent. How much work goes into that? Because you're clearly not American. I wonder.
Very Irish.
Very Irish.
Well, I was born in New York. So technically I'm a New Yorker, but moved back when I was about 3 years old and never really kind of had the American accent. But I grew up watching things like Seinfeld and, you know, stuff like that. So I think that just really opened up my ear to different sounds and just how people talk. And also, whenever my dad and I would just be messing around, we'd always do accents. That was kind of the automatic thing for us to do. So it was always a fun thing for me to do, and I was kind of used to doing it.
All right, where was I?
You were gonna ask us something.
Oh, that's right. Thanks. Okay, so here goes. My partner weighs in at about 95 pounds, right? And together you guys are pushing half a ton, give or take, correct? So, did you need much help stuffing her in that garbage can? Now, I usually don't talk to people like you in the first place, but if I did that sort of thing, I would say that you girls should have your own TV show, and that they should call that program The Adventures of Donnie's Bitches. But like I said at the top, I usually don't talk to people like you. Be your best in my new signature dress. Let them know you mean business at the disco or in the boardroom with the amazing versatility of the premiere piece and my high-end line of super stylish couture. Who's better than you, girl? Oh, man! There's a real good chance those dorks will foul everything up for us if we do it like this. I mean, Donnie's guys could even wind up with the credit if they trace the gun and boss would try to weasel out of paying us. Even worse, we might get blamed for every corpse in here. And boss would shaft us to the hilt on account of unnecessary roughness. Not to mention the gang war we might have already started. And it's not even like we can switch out the bullets because the calibers wouldn't begin to match the ones on our styling rods. So, like I said, you can do it your way if you want to, but we risk looking unprofessional and getting screwed out of a couple of hot dresses. I got news for you, number one. Given the situation, I see why you're TO'd and all, but what's done is done, and my partner comes first.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means that if you try to take her out or get in the middle of our job, you're in for a world of hurt. I know what you're capable of, and we're pros too. We also know that you're coming now.
Daisy's not really a killer. She hasn't got a killer mentality. For me, it was more about bringing out her caring side and how gentle she is. I know that's not what people are expecting.
You just missed her.
Days?
She just left.
Who?
Rose.
Was she alive?
I don't know. But she asked about you.
What did she say?
She said, I'm looking for your partner. Those were her exact words.
Is that all she said?
No. She said that roses were dead and violets were too. She split after that and that was the end of it.
How long have you been here?
She's taller than I thought.
How long have you been here, Days?
I can't really tell. Time is bent up now, so I don't know. I keep missing my flights.
So what are you trying to say?
I just said it.
Say it again if you have the guts.
You heard me.
I'm gonna kick your ass!
I was a friend of your father's. I just wanted to let you know that I was a friend of his and that he talked about you a lot. He wanted me to give something to you, too.
What is it?
It's the new Barbie Sunday dress.
For real?
Yeah. I think it should fit. There's something else in there, too.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Your father was a good guy, April. He told me how you two got lost in the mall one day and then had ice cream.
Think about you learning English from Seinfeld, that is very...
It's talking like George Costanza all of a sudden, you know? Like, wow, what a weird 10-year-old.
See you, Daze.